The house is astonishing. Every room is beautiful, and I'm still slapping myself in disbelief at having been given this for the summer. Michael's right. Haswell's going to work me half to death for this. The main bedroom is an eye-opener. Michael unpacking, laying out clothes and other holiday essentials in his normal, well-organized way. Charlotte simply stares out of the window. It's a vast panoramic view, the sea in silver, gray and green, from one horizon to the other, with only the odd boat, tiny and remote, to break the panorama. But as I survey the bedroom, the view isn't the only item of interest. I smile inwardly. It's obvious, really. He just doesn't flaunt it. Charlotte turns, watching my gaze sweep the room.
Something wrong, Master?
Not at all. I was just wondering about Richard Haswell's inclinations. I wink at her, and wait. Her nose wrinkles as she looks around the room, not getting it. Come on, Jade Eyes. You're brighter than that. Then her eyes widen as she bursts out laughing as she notices. The four-postered bed, solidly built with thick timber supports and thick brass rings. The suspended basket chair, again sturdily supported from the ceiling on a heavy-duty brass hook. Both would easily support a human body.
You think this is a playroom, disguised as a bedroom, Master?
I flash brows at her, waiting for a reaction. Let's say that I think it would be very easy to adapt it for other uses than sleeping. Her face is flushing, predictable as ever. Her pupils are dilating, and as I wait, I scent her. Glancing across, Michael has already tuned in, and now facing us, is grinning broadly. Yup, he knows she's getting horny too. And looking in more closely, her skin is beginning to sheen. I'd say that's our cue. Michael and I meet eyes and then look back at her. She stares at us, then blushes even redder.
How do you both know?
She demands, shaking her head, radiating frustration. Michael, eyes crinkled in humor, moves close by her, wrapping an arm around her.
Oh, Charlotte. Sorry, but when you feel horny, you are completely transparent.
She looks baffled, but still horny. What do you think of that pool? I suggest, waggling my eyebrows at her. It's pretty private here. No one's going to disturb us. Her eyes widen, flashing between the two of us. Her lips are parting, her chest heaving, and that flush is blooming over face and neck and breasts.
Oh, you too.
Michael's eyes meet mine again. Then he tightens his hold on her shoulders.
Do you want to fuck?
He asks. Or do you want to make love? I say. Her chin lifts and she attempts, and fails, to muster a lofty air.
I want to have holiday fun, and I want to have it with my two lovers.
Her eyes move between us.
Preferably with them not behaving as though my brain is a notice board.
Michael's eyes sparkle and I catch his mood. Her eyes widen as she realizes what we're about to do. We move in as a pair, hooking arms under hers. Scooping her up, we carry her outside, shrieking with laughter as we go. At the poolside, in a matter-of-fact kind of way, I unbelt her robe as Michael tugs it away from her. Then, with complete lack of ceremony, shoves her between the shoulders to drop her, naked and spluttering, into the water. Michael strips off his own robe and leaps in after her. I undress by the poolside and dive in, catching up with the pair in time for Michael, sitting on the steps, to pull her back against himself. His arm curved around her. She's both anchored and safe. As I swim close, he whispers something to her. She nods and allows herself to float, her legs drifting open as she relaxes back against his chest. It's shallow here, enough so that I can kneel between her legs. And with the water taking the bulk of her weight, it's easy for me to nudge her legs over my shoulders and close in between her smooth, pale thighs